Hey, go homie, it's Natalie.
And Lena here with your GPA TV announcements,
weather, and sports.
And GPA TV starts right now.
And I'm running for ASB president. The reason you should vote for me is I want to make the school year exciting, and I want to listen to your ideas and try to implement them into all of our activities. This year, we're changing up the ASB structure a bit, and I know that with these new changes that we'll make the whole school a lot more fun and a better place to be. This school will next year be a place for everyone to be themselves and to make their changes that they want to. I've been ASB since fifth grade, so I know things that we could make changes to, and I want to make sure everyone has a good education but is also having fun at the same time. And that's why you should vote for me for ASB president.
My name is Sarah Russell, and I want to be your ASB secretary. I've been in ASB since fifth grade, and I haven't run for a position yet, but I want to now. In ASB, the secretary's job is to make sure all information gets written down, and we keep track of it. I'm really good at keeping track of everything we do, as I already do that for my groups in ASB this year. It would be a good idea for you guys to vote for me in for as secretary, because I always listen to what people have to say, and I write it down to make sure it gets heard. So vote for me for ASB secretary.
Hi, my name is Chloe Brown, and I'm running for middle school ASB treasurer. My three best traits are that I'm hardworking, trustworthy, and dependable. I believe that I will be a great treasurer for middle school ASB. I'm good with numbers, and I'm very responsible, and I will do my best to attend all the executive council meetings. I will also meet all the needs of the job a treasurer requires. So please, vote for me, Chloe Brown, for your middle school treasurer.
Congratulations to the middle school orchestra that placed first in the Music in Parks Festival at Knott's Berry Farm.
And also, congratulations to middle school choir for placing second.
On Wednesday, May 23rd, from 6 to 8 p.m. in the gym, there will be an annual sports banquet for all athletes.
The dinner is optional for $5. It will be from 6 to 7 p.m. Then the award ceremony will start at 7.
Please pick up and return the dinner tickets to Mr. Warren by Friday, May 18th.
Sounds like a lot of fun.
Now let's go watch weather with Eric.
Hey, Guam, it's Eric with this week's weather. This week we have a high of 67 and a low of 54. Also expect sunny to partly cloudy skies this week. In the mid-Atlantic states, severe storms, damaging winds, large hail, and tornado threats are in effect, with damaging wind, hail, and heavy rain being the main threats. I hope everyone stays safe and is okay. This has been Eric with your weekly weather. Now back to the studio.
Attention all middle school 8th graders, promotion day is just around the corner.
Save time and don't worry about not having a lei to wear on your special day.
Key Club is sponsoring Orchid and Custom Kukui Nut Leis sales. The leis will be delivered to you before the ceremony begins.
Go to kahunafundraising.com and search for Guajome Park Academy Charter, then place your order today.
The last day to order is Saturday, May 26th.
Now let's go watch sports with Tanner.
Hey Guajome, it's Tanner and I'm here with this week's sports. The girls softball team is going to the playoffs with a record of 14-5. Good luck. Our track team finished their conference finals and four students made it into the CIF prelims. Sophia Nervig, 100 hurdles. Jared Nagata, 110 and 300 hurdles. Michael Simmons, shot put. Tori Ribbons, shot put. With one game remaining, our middle school team got with a 2-0 win over Madison, bringing their season record to 3 wins, 1 loss, and 1 tie. Playoffs will begin on May 22nd, and finals will be on the 25th. All athletes who are planning to play sports next year, on Monday, May 21st, from 3 to 5 p.m., you will be able to get a physical. Cost will be $25. Don't miss out on the opportunity. That's all for today, Guajome. Now back to the studio.
There are only 100 yearbooks left. If you have not ordered our yearbook yet, you need to do it immediately.
The books now cost $75. Visit Ms. Pratt in room 3119 or Ms. Tavares in the finance office to order.
We will sell out, so don't wait till the end of the year.
I can't wait to get the yearbooks.
Yeah, me too. Have you ever tried knitting, Lena?
No, I haven't, but I heard Natalie Taylor did a news story on knitting and crafting in Guajome.
Let's go check it out.
There are many clubs here at Guajome. A few are Science Club, Tennis Club, and Anime Club. One club being Knitting and Crafting Club that meets in room 4138 on Mondays at 3:15 to 4.
What we do in Knitting and Crafting Club is we learn how to knit and we make other types of crafts like paper crafts, ribbon crafts. We're making some felt crafts right now for spring and for Mother's Day. Someone might want to join this club if they're interested in doing any types of crafts. If they want to learn how to knit or crochet, we do that too. So it's just a really creative outlet if they like to do creative things. My goals for this club, or our goals for our club, is to bring students together through the art of making crafts and through knitting and learning how to knit. And even eventually down the road, give back to our community, maybe by making some knit hats and things like that for some of the other hospitals and care facilities around that take care of cancer patients who need knit hats. We make projects for the holidays, holiday theme projects, and knitting projects. We get funds from selling the things that we make. So if you ever see us out there at a lunchtime, holidays are coming up, come by our table and look and see what we've got. We've got something great for you.
My favorite part of this club is that I get to interact with different people and we get to do different projects. I think I would recommend this to other people if they like doing art and knitting, because you get to express yourself in different ways.
My favorite part about this club is that I get to interact with people that I didn't know and that I get to be with a good teacher. I would recommend this club because you can make new stuff that for your room or decorations, or you can make stuff for your family.
Led by Miss Marley, Crafting and Knitting Club is one of the many amazing clubs you can join here at Guahome. If you want an exciting, fun, and crafty after-school activity, Knitting and Crafting Club is the club for you. This has been Natalie Taylor, reporting for GPA-TV.
That seems like a lot of fun.
Yeah, I was never really a crafty person, but I think that the club would really bring out my creative side.
Yeah, me too, and I really like the idea that they give some of their things away to charity.
Great job, Natalie. Do you still have a library book that you need to turn in?
It's never too late to turn it in, especially if you are all done with it.
And if you are not done, then renew it.
Well, that seems to be all the time we have for today, Guahome. It's been Natalie
and Lena
signing out.